There are pros and cons of using just the GRE or just an IPSec tunnel, so what if we could combine both? Today we'll be exploring GRE over IPSec, which gives us both flexibility and security, which each protocol by itself fails to do. In the on-screen example, we have two corporate sites connected by a bog-standard internet. This could be a DIA, a broadband connection, something like that, but either way, it's public and it's not secure. To make it secure, we could just use IPSec, but as that only supports unicast, it will break our routing protocol, EIGRP. Now, it sends hellos and updates using multicast. So what we need from EIGRP is to learn the LAN subnets from each site. So router A would learn router B's subnets and vice versa. And we don't want that to break, obviously. So to make all that work, we could create a GRE tunnel for our data to live in and then encrypt everything in the IPSec, a bit like foam lagging around a water pipe, which protects it from freezing. IPSec surrounds the packets and prevents them from being read if intercepted. It would be common to come across these kind of constructs in a DMVPN environment or with certain service provider connections, particularly in Europe, and perhaps in some early SD-WAN deployments. Before doing any configuration, I want to demonstrate that a GRE tunnel by itself is not going to encrypt traffic. So I'll fire up Wireshark on router 2 and show you that a telnet password can still be seen in plain text. Now Wireshark is open, and we can see some of our just normal EIGRP traffic that we expect as we've got that running on the network. I'll just minimize that for a moment. So on here, we'll just go telnet 10.2.1.1, which is router 1's loopback address, router 2's loopback address, sorry. We get prompted for our password. We've entered that and we're now over in router 2. I'll just disconnect there, because the damage is already done. If we have a look in our capture, we can see telnet packets here. And the problem with telnet is that it gives you the individual characters that are being pressed on the keyboard. So here we can see a T, here we can see an E down in the data section, etc. S. So very easily in Wireshark, you can just follow the TCP stream and then it will print it out on screen for you. So anyone that's sat in the middle, man in the middle, can see your password in clear text just using the GRE tunnel. Encrypting our traffic with IPSec forms several distinct sections. So we have phase one, which is our ISOCAMP portion of the tunnel. Essentially here we have to establish a connection between the two routers at either end and establish some kind of trust there between the two routers. And then once that portion has been accepted, then we can move on with phase two, which is our security association for IPSec. And in that, we can say what type of encryption we want to use, what type of authentication protocols we want to use. We can set other things like perfect forward secrecy, different Diffie-Hellman groups, things that we're not going to delve into today, but it's something that you could read about if you wanted to find out more. And then finally, we apply the configuration that we've got to our tunnel. Now, this is all using what's called a virtual tunnel interface, or VTI. There are other ways of doing this as well. There are more legacy methods where you have to configure ACLs and maps and things like that so that you can actually define which subnets get encrypted. But with the VTI model, we're essentially applying it to the GRE tunnel. So everything that goes over the GRE tunnel is encrypted with IPSec. And I've put a little memory aid at the bottom there, which is policeman's keys transform professional tusslers. So it's a bit of a silly one, but essentially it takes the first letter, or more letters in this case actually, from each of the individual pieces that need to be configured. So we have our policy, which is policeman's key, keys, transform, profile, professional, and tunnel to tusslers. So let's get to the configuration. I've brought up both routers on screen, and we'll configure the IPSec between the two nodes. So first of all, we'll start with our policy. So enter the command crypto isocamp policy and then give it a policy number, and just define the authentication method that we want to use, which is pre-shared. And then we enter our pre-shared key, if we exit out of that mode back into main configuration mode. So crypto isocamp key. And then we basically give it a password. So we'll just give it the password. And then address, and then the public IP address of the other node. So 203.0.113. And it's .5 on our diagram up there. Okay, and those keys have to match on both routers. Obviously the IP address will be different for each, but the password must match. And then once we've entered that piece, we do our transform set. So that's crypto IPSec transform set, and then we'll just give it a name, my set, and then we choose the encryption method that we want, which I'm going to choose AES, and then the authentication method, which I will choose SHA-256. Okay, and then we can exit out of that mode. And then we just define our profile. So CryptoIPSEC profile. And then we give our profile a name. Keep it simple. My profile. And we bind our transform set to it. So our transform set was called my set. Can't spell my set. There we go. And the final piece of the puzzle is to bind the entire thing, so the profile, to the tunnel interface. So we'll go to tunnel one, and we will go tunnel protection IPSec profile, and then we'll call it we'll define our profile, which is my profile, and there we go. That should be bound there. We'll get some error messages here because the other side isn't configured. So the tunnel itself has gone down, the neighborship's gone down there, until we configure the other side. So let me just quickly run through that on the other side as well. Okay, and now that's been configured on both sides, we can see our adjacency is up again. Finally, let's just run a few commands to make sure that we've got our IPSec tunnel working correctly, and that the traffic that's passing through it is encrypted. We'll do that again with another Wireshark capture. So what we'll do is show crypto isocamp SA. And we can see that we've got a connection here between our two devices, well, between our devices, and it's in the QM idle state, which means that that part of the tunnel, that phase of the tunnel, has been created and it's sat there idle now because IPSec phase two has taken over. So that's good, that's what we want to see. And then show crypto IPSec SA. It's a far more there's far more output there in this command, but the main bit is at the top that we can see that we're getting packets encapsulated, encrypted, and decapsulation and decryption from the other side as well. That increments quite slowly, so we can always kind of push that along a bit to make sure that our packet's being encrypted. If we ping 10.1.1.1, which is a loopback address on router 1 from router 2, and source that from our own local subnet 2.1.1, and then we can repeat that ping 1,000 times, and we should see the packets encapsulated, decapsulated, increment very quickly. And we run that command again. And we can see that we've added 1,000 onto this encapsulation and decapsulation just by sending that ping. So it's going down the tunnel and being encrypted. I'm going to start up my Wireshark capture again on router 2, and we'll do the same test again. So we'll do another telnet from router 1 to router 2 and see what happens, see if we can still see our top secret password. Wireshark's up and running, so let's go in here, do our telnet again. 10.2.1.1. And then we'll enter our password. Top secret. And we're on to router 2. So we'll stop our Wireshark capture. We can see now that the majority of packets are labeled ESP under the protocol column. And that is because of the IPSec encryption. Now, before we could see each individual telnet packet, we could see individual EIGRP packets. And then we could actually delve into those and see the parameters to actually follow the TCP stream and grab the password. Now we can't do that. That is all encrypted with IPSec. Check out my website, rightmem.co.uk, for all my latest blogs. And also you can find my video content at my YouTube channel, which is RightMemTV. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like and check out some more of my videos. Thanks for watching.